Do you ever just feel blah? I don't know what words to use for it. It's no secret that I'm not very good with most emotions. I express happiness and anger very well, but the other emotions are kind of a jumble to me. But I feel blah. James was home this weekend, and his aunt and cousin were here. They wanted me to help them pick out Ryan's first car as he's turning 18 next week, and of course he wanted a Ford Mustang. So I spent Saturday test driving and dealing with the nice folks at our local Ford dealership, and we did in fact drive away with a really cool white Mustang. I love this process, shopping for and negotiating the price on a car, and I know most people would rather have root canal surgery, but I really enjoy it. But all weekend, even doing stuff I love, with people I love, I just felt blah. I still laughed a bit and had a good lunch. I enjoyed watching a movie yesterday with James before he went back to Georgia Tech, but I felt blah. In fact, I felt blah preaching yesterday. I hope the sermon itself wasn't blah. I don't know the last time I wasn't overjoyed at the prospect of sharing God's word with others, but yesterday? Blah. And this morning? Well, more blah. I don't know how to describe it except that the sound that the word blah makes when you really sound it out, blah, is about how my insides feel right now. I think I know what's causing it. It's grief. Thoughts about my dad, his failed health, and my inability to visit across an international border during COVID. These are almost always in the back of my mind, lurking, waiting to leap out at me. I usually keep these thoughts at bay because I'm powerless to do anything about them. When they do pop into my mind, I turn to God. I turn to my Heavenly Father in prayer, and I commit the situation to Him. And somehow, after prayer, I don't feel so powerless because I'm reminded that God is powerful and that God is in charge. And I feel a deep sense of relief and release from all of this. But not this weekend. These thoughts stuck with me. They kept me awake at night. And then my friend Alan Bickford's physical demise over the last few weeks and finally his death on Thursday. And then hearing the news while at the car dealership that my friend Matt died on Saturday at just 47 years old. I can't seem to stop pondering the demise and death of those I love. I feel like I've pitched my tent in the valley of blah. It's been a rough weekend, to be honest with you. In Psalm 30, verse 5, David wrote, "Weeping may last for the night, but joy comes with the morning." David knew a thing or two about feeling blah. I'm sure he was more in tune emotionally and had a deeper vocabulary to use, but I'll use the word blah. The anointed king had to live in hiding like a bandit, fearing for his life from the madness of King Saul. Then after he became king, David had many more blah moments. His public sin and shame, the death of the child with his illicit relationship with Bathsheba, incest among his children, fratricide among his children because of the incest, and the list goes on. But David understood that feeling blah didn't last forever. And if he could get beyond these terrible tragedies, then there's hope for me, there's hope for us. The wonderful thing about tents is their impermanence. We can set them up in the valley of blah for the weekend. But folks, a tent, it's easy to relocate. I'm praying that after the funeral for Alan tomorrow, the Lord will help me strike the tent in the valley of blah and relocate it in the sunshine peak where I usually dwell. To paraphrase David, blah may last for the weekend, but the joy of the Lord is never far away. Amen.